What exactly happened during Flight 8 of SpaceX's Starship Super Heavy? Let's discuss in detail. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. On Thursday, March 6th, 2025, SpaceX conducted its 8th test flight of the Starship megarocket system, marking another significant step in the development of the world's largest and most powerful launch vehicle. The mission, which lifted off at 5:30 p.m. CT from SpaceX's Starbase facility in South Texas, achieved several key objectives while also encountering challenges reminiscent of previous flights. The launch of Starship Flight 8 came after multiple delays and rescheduling. Initially planned for earlier in the week, SpaceX had to postpone the launch due to technical issues with both the first and second stages, as well as weather-related concerns. The company's commitment to safety and thorough pre-flight checks was evident in these decisions, demonstrating the complex nature of such ambitious spaceflight endeavors. As the launch window opened on Thursday evening, the massive 400-foot-tall Starship, consisting of the Super Heavy booster, Booster 15, and the Starship upper stage, Ship 34, ignited its 33 Raptor engines in a spectacular display of power. The liftoff was smooth, with the vehicle clearing the launch tower and beginning its ascent into the sky above Boca Chica Beach, Texas. One of the most anticipated aspects of Flight 8 was the performance and attempted recovery of Booster 15. This super heavy booster incorporated several upgrades based on lessons learned from previous flights, including upgraded avionics, a more powerful flight computer, enhanced power and network distribution, and integrated smart batteries. These improvements were designed to increase the reliability and performance of the booster during its critical phases of flight. Approximately 2.5 minutes into the mission, Booster 15 successfully separated from Ship 34, beginning its descent back to Earth. In a significant achievement for SpaceX, Booster 15 executed a precise series of maneuvers, including a boost back burn and a landing burn, before being successfully caught by the launch tower's mechanical arms, known as chopsticks. This marked the third successful retrieval of a Super Heavy booster, and only the second instance where SpaceX achieved both a Starship launch and a Super Heavy booster catch in the same mission. The successful catch of Booster 15 represents a crucial milestone in SpaceX's goal of rapid reusability. By catching the booster with the tower arms, the company aims to reduce turnaround time between launches and minimize refurbishment costs. This achievement brings SpaceX one step closer to its vision of a fully reusable launch system capable of supporting frequent missions to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. While the launch and booster recovery were successful, Ship 34 encountered a significant anomaly during its flight, reminiscent of the issues faced during Flight 7. As the upper stage continued its suborbital trajectory across the Gulf of Mexico, reports emerged of a possible engine explosion. A video circulating on X, formerly Twitter, has sparked speculation about a potential engine explosion in Ship 34's engine bay. The footage, captured on one of SpaceX's monitors, shows what appears to be an explosion within the spacecraft's engine compartment. What do you think? Is this anomaly due to an engine explosion? Comment below, let me know. While the video does resemble an engine explosion, it's important to note that SpaceX has not yet officially confirmed the nature of the incident. The anomaly with Ship 34 bears similarities to the incident that occurred during Flight 7, where Ship 33 was lost due to a leak in the propulsion system. Based on the information available from the Flight 7 investigation, several other potential causes for the Ship 34 anomaly can be explored. One possibility is that harmonic oscillations in the propulsion system led to a leak above the engine bay shielding and below the aft dome, an area referred to as the attic. These oscillations may have persisted in Ship 34, despite attempts to mitigate them. Another potential cause could be a propellant line rupture. The powerful vibrations caused by harmonic oscillations could have led to the rupture of propellant lines, resulting in an uncontrolled leak and potential engine explosion. Given the reports of a possible engine explosion, there may have been a critical failure in one or more of Ship 34's Raptor engines during the high-stress re-entry phase. The thermal protection system could also be a factor in the anomaly. SpaceX intentionally removed some heat shield tiles from Ship 34 to stress test vulnerable areas. This experimental approach may have led to unexpected thermal issues during re-entry. Additionally, the re-entry profile was designed to intentionally stress the structural limits of the upper stage's rear flaps at the point of maximum entry, dynamic pressure. This extreme testing may have exceeded the vehicle's capabilities. Prior to Flight 8, SpaceX had implemented several improvements to address the issues encountered in previous flights. Ship 34 featured redesigned forward flaps to reduce re-entry heat exposure and simplify mechanisms. The Starship upper stage's propulsion system gained a 25% boost in propellant volume to enable longer flights. Extra vents were added to the aft section of Ship 34 to mitigate issues encountered on Ship 33 during Flight 7. SpaceX also conducted an extended static fire test with Ship 34, lasting nearly a minute, to test new hardware and cycle the Raptor engines through multiple thrust levels. Despite these improvements, the anomaly with Ship 34 suggests that further refinements may be necessary to achieve consistent success with the Starship upper stage. The data gathered from this flight will be invaluable for future improvements to the Starship system. Flight 8 was designed to achieve several objectives that were not met during the previous test flight. For the first time, Starship attempted to deploy a payload consisting of four Starlink satellite simulators. The mission included multiple re-entry experiments aimed at gathering data for future missions where the upper stage would return to the launch site for recovery. A single Raptor engine relight in space was planned to test the vehicle's ability to perform orbital maneuvers. SpaceX also intentionally removed some heat shield tiles to assess the performance of the thermal protection system under stress. While the full extent of these objectives' completion is not yet known due to the anomaly, the data gathered from this flight will be crucial for refining the Starship system and addressing the challenges encountered during the mission. The launch of Flight 8 came after SpaceX completed a comprehensive safety review and received approval from the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA. The FAA issued a license modification for Flight 8 and beyond, allowing for certain operational changes, such as the installation and removal procedures for the flight termination system. It's worth noting that while SpaceX received clearance for Flight 8, the mishap investigation for Flight 7 was still ongoing at the time of launch. This highlights the complex regulatory environment in which SpaceX operates and the company's ability to address safety concerns while continuing its ambitious test program. The mixed results of Starship Flight 8, with the successful booster catch contrasted against the Ship 34 anomaly, underscore the challenges inherent in developing a revolutionary space transportation system. SpaceX's iterative approach to testing and development has allowed the company to make rapid progress, but it also means accepting a degree of risk and learning from failures. As SpaceX analyzes the data from Flight 8, several key areas will likely be focus points for future improvements. Addressing the persistent issues with harmonic oscillations and potential propellant line failures will be crucial for achieving consistent success with the Starship upper stage. Refining the heat shield design and testing procedures to ensure the vehicle can withstand the extreme conditions of atmospheric re-entry will also be a priority. Investigating the possible engine explosion on Ship 34 and implementing measures to prevent similar occurrences in future flights will be essential for enhancing the reliability of the Raptor engines. Evaluating the vehicle's ability to withstand the intentional stresses imposed during testing and making necessary adjustments to the design will be crucial for ensuring the structural integrity of future Starship vehicles. While the booster catch was successful, continuing to refine this process will be essential for achieving rapid reusability and minimizing turnaround time between launches. The successful aspects of Flight 8, particularly the booster recovery, demonstrate significant progress in key areas of the Starship program. The ability to catch and reuse the Super Heavy booster is a critical component of SpaceX's vision for a fully reusable launch system. This achievement not only reduces the cost per launch, but also paves the way for more frequent and sustainable space exploration missions. The booster catch technique, using the launch tower's mechanical arms, is a novel approach that could revolutionize rocket recovery. Traditional methods of landing boosters on drone ships or land-based pads require significant resources and time for recovery and refurbishment. By catching the booster directly at the launch site, SpaceX aims to streamline the process, potentially enabling multiple launches per day from the same pad. However, the anomaly experienced by Ship 34 during re-entry serves as a reminder of the immense challenges involved in developing a fully reusable upper stage capable of withstanding the extreme conditions of atmospheric re-entry. The Starship upper stage must not only survive the intense heat and forces of re-entry, but also maintain its structural integrity and the functionality of its propulsion systems for potential landing and reuse. The possible engine explosion reported during Ship 34's re-entry highlights the complexity of the Raptor engine system and the need for further refinement. The Raptor engines, which use a full-flow staged combustion cycle, are among the most advanced rocket engines ever developed. Their ability to operate efficiently in both sea level and vacuum conditions is crucial for the Starship's mission profile. But this versatility also introduces additional complexity and potential failure points. As SpaceX continues to analyze the data from Flight 8 and implement necessary improvements, the company faces the challenge of balancing rapid development with safety and reliability. The iterative approach that has served SpaceX well in the past must now be applied to solving the complex issues encountered during high-stress phases of flight, particularly during re-entry. The ongoing development of Starship has significant implications for the future of space exploration and commercialization. The vehicle's large payload capacity and potential for full reusability could dramatically reduce the cost of access to space, enabling more ambitious missions to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. The success of the Starship program could also have far-reaching effects on the global space industry, potentially disrupting traditional launch markets and opening up new possibilities for space-based research and commerce. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.